It's Mission Radio here, proudly brought to you by Musashi, the day before UFC 246, Conor McGregor versus Cowboy Cerrone, with the man himself, UFC President Dana White. The weigh-in's just wrapped up. I've never seen you so far away for a Conor McGregor face-off on the stage. Is this the most relaxed you've ever been for a Conor McGregor face-off?
No, the girl that I had in the middle there was Summer, the girl from Best Buy that went viral. I'm giving her the weekend of her life, so I had her stand in the middle, and I'm pretty confident that if anything went down, she could have handled it.
I love it. Summer should be at every UFC event, especially if the Khabib rematch happens. Let's just quickly mention the fact that it has been quite respectful. There's been sort of a different build-up, a different Conor McGregor. A lot of people are excited to see him return, but I'm just wondering, in terms of forecast for pay-per-view buys and people buying the event, how's it looking compared to some of the crazier build-ups that we've seen in the past?
Off the charts.
Wow.
Off the charts. This thing is going to do numbers that we did when we were on traditional pay-per-view. And internationally, it's just, this is a massive fight. So here, there's an $11 million gate here, okay? $11 million, so we've been opening up production kills and putting these tickets on sale. Today, we started selling standing room only. There's people paying to stand up in the rafters and watch the fight. This place is going to be insane tomorrow night.
So what do you attribute that to? Because I think general thinking, you know, early parts of Conor McGregor's career, he was so captivating with the trash talk. Of course, his performances, but, you know, that was a big part of it. The Khabib rematch, obviously, so much bad blood. But you're saying this one, A, is it bigger than the Khabib rematch? And B, why do you think it is so big? What is it about this fight?
First of all, if you look at what Conor's gone through over the last couple of years, you know, from all the madness, you know, losing the Khabib fight to legal troubles and all this stuff, people are interested to see, can he come back? And Cowboy is a real fight, especially at 170. You know, so people are interested. People love this kid.
Well, you hit the nail on the head. There's so many questions, right? Conor, what does he look like after his comeback? Conor going back up to 170, weighing in today, the heaviest he's ever been, in the past about 168. Today, hit the nail on 170. So for you personally, what is the biggest question that you have about Conor that you want answered this weekend that you're curious about?
I don't like Conor at 170. I never did, and I don't now. This guy was 145-pound champion, and he's fighting 170-pound. That's such a huge jump. You know, but that's what makes Conor, and that's why everybody loves him. But when you look at this fight, it's two of the most beloved fighters in UFC history facing off against each other, and people care.
I'm just wondering, he wants to have a season. He keeps calling it that. We haven't heard an MMA fighter speak about the sport like that before. But obviously, Tony's fighting Khabib in April. We hope the fight's going to happen. And if that happens, and McGregor can't step in to fight one of those guys, it looks like he wouldn't be fighting for quite some time. You know, Khabib likes to take some time off if he wins. Would that be one of the sort of decision motivators, if he looks good at 170, behind looking at possibly giving him a guy like Masvidal and the time being, keep him busy?
Listen, me and Conor will fight about this in private. I don't like the Masvidal fight, and it pisses him off when I say that. I would rather have him wait for Khabib and fight Khabib. So, but most of my arguments with Conor McGregor, I don't win, so we'll see what happens.
Because I'm just curious, obviously Leon Edwards and Tyron Woodley, another fantastic fight, is going to be going down. Would those guys sort of be looking at that number one contendership if this Masvidal-Conor McGregor thing happens? And Masvidal sort of doesn't fight Usman next?
Masvidal should fight Usman next. That's the fight to make.
I feel like that Nate Diaz-Masvidal fight was kind of made immediately post-fight when Nate Diaz won. Could this be a similar situation where, you know, Masvidal's going to be here this weekend. He's going to be in the crowd.
He's here. I just saw him.
Yeah. He's been here the whole week, but he's going to be at the fight. If Conor, say, wins, says something to Masvidal, they go back and forth.
It could be in a situation. They start early before you have a chance to even
commission
anything.
You might have to make that fight, right?
Nah.
What if the fans demand it?
When do I not give the fans what the fans want? And when do I not give Conor or even Israel? Look at Israel. Israel wants to fight the nastiest, meanest dude in the division when that guy isn't next in line for a title. He can sit around and wait for the Costa fight. He wants to fight the guy that literally nobody wants to fight. Nobody wants to fight, Romero. Nobody wants that fight. And the fact that he wants it, I respect it so much, he's getting the fight, you know? So, listen, I have my ideas of how things should go and who should do what, but it doesn't always go that way. Look at right now, Aldo and Cejudo want to fight, right? We're going to do it. So, we'll see how this whole thing plays out.
I'm just wondering, when Israel was talking to about, because we're super excited for the fight, obviously in Australasia, it's going to be absolutely huge in Australia and New Zealand, but and all over the world. But when he was talking to you about that Yoel Romero fight, was it a similar situation to the Masvidal thing where you were trying to sort of
Are you kidding me? We're in matchmaking meetings, and everybody's head explodes when we talk about that fight. And because, you know, the fight to make is Israel versus Costa. That's the fight to make. But the fact that the champion wants this fight and wants to fight the nastiest, meanest dude out there, you have to respect it.
Does this move him any closer to a John Jones fight, you know, assuming John Jones's career goes, you know, the correct trajectory and he gets past Dominic Reyes?
What I think needs to happen is Israel, and Israel's on track. Israel's calling out Romero. They'll fight. He beats Romero. Costa's next. If he beats Costa, you know, maybe there's one more guy there that would make sense, that you'd be like, damn, I got to see Israel. Israel can't beat this guy. Gets that fight, beats him, and then you start talking about John Jones if Israel really wants that fight. But if you ask me, I think Israel should stay where he's at, keep picking these guys off for as long as he can, and just build this phenomenal legacy.
Mm. Would that be a Raiders stadium, you think, if that ever came together, John Jones, Israel Adesanya? Would you look at a stadium sort of?
Yeah, I think what you do with that, you do a stadium in either New Zealand or Australia.
I can't lie, I'm happy to hear that, but I'm sure everybody watching it over here. But
I've been building that market for the last however many years, and it's finally, we're there. Mm. Australia, New Zealand, it's real. That's legit. There's legit fighters coming from that part of the world. The fans are insane, incredible.
Good media and as well.
Great media. Yeah. No, it's true. There is great. Yeah. Great media, everything. It's a real market now. It's a real market. You know, I've been building it forever. The fans have been super loyal and supportive there. We'll bring real fights there now.
And it's a great thing seeing yourself and the UFC obviously donating over $250,000, you know, to the Red Cross to help, you know, with the fires. redcross.org.au/UFC. Dan is wearing the T-shirt right now.
Very comfortable.
I know you're busy, Dana, so we'll let you go in a moment. Just a couple more questions about, you know, the Australasian market. UFC 248, Israel versus Romero. We're going to have Robert Whittaker taking on Jared Cannonier. Whittaker is now out of that card. What exactly happened there?
Let me put it to you this way. That's personal. For Whittaker, if Whittaker wants to talk about that, he can. But I'll tell you this, when you talk about somebody whose priorities are in the right place, who is completely selfless and down to the core, a good human being, that's Robert Whittaker. Mm. The reason Robert Whittaker is not fighting in this fight is one of the most unselfish things I've ever seen in my life. He's a good man. He's a good human being. And I have a lot of respect for him. And, you know, good luck to him and what he's dealing with right now. And I can't put into words and articulate how I feel about Robert Whittaker. He's the real deal, man.
I know it might sort of be hard to say now, but is there a rough timeline of when he may return? Could he return this year? Is it likely?
You got to ask him that question. He's dealing with some personal issues. And what he's doing and how he's handling it, I have so much respect for him. Mm. So
a huge star in the Australasian market. Just speaking of Canada, we saw that Darren Till said he's planning a trip to Las Vegas around March. Could it be Darren Till versus Jared Cannonier on that card? Is he in contention to have that fight?
Yeah, I mean, listen, Till's a bad boy. You know, he could fight any of the top guys right now. You know, we'll see how this plays out.
Final thing, Alex Volkanovski would kill us if we didn't ask. He's sort of saying that the guys in the featherweight division, you know, guys like Korean Zombie and everyone else, they need to work their way up to him and have one more fight and prove something. What do you think about that? And in your mind, is it Max rematch next, or do you think, you know, it might be something else?
Tell Volkanovski we'll worry about that. The next fight is Holloway. It's the rematch with Holloway, yeah.
And I'm just wondering, obviously, that ANZ Stadium in Sydney is a place where we've been looking at for Alex to potentially have this first title defense. Would you look at Alex defending his title in Australia once he gets better?
Sure.
And would ANZ Stadium in Sydney be the place that you think it could happen?
I don't know, but yeah, we'll do it there. Like I said, we're going to bring real fights there.
Well, what can you say except for the fact that the UFC Australia t-shirt is out. It is soft. It is comfortable. I've gotten a couple looks from people. Actually, it makes me look a little bit thinner. I like that too.
Oh, there you go.
It's some good designs here.
I'm always in black.
You guys can buy it right now, of course, and all the proceeds go towards the bushfires, another fantastic cause that Dana White and the UFC are behind. Thank you so much,
Thank
boss,
you.
For
Thanks
speaking
for the
to
kind
us.
Words. I appreciate
Thank
it.
You.